Heavenly Father, we pray for the Dominican Republic. It's a nation that is in great need of you. Father, I pray for repentance on behalf of the country. I pray, Father, that our hearts would just bow before you in humility, recognizing the need of you, our Savior. Lord, I pray for the nation's leadership, for all government officials, that they will bow before you and worship you as God. I pray, Father, for those in uniforms and authority, that they will exercise it justly. I pray, Lord Jesus, for those men and women that you have called yours and set aside to preach the word. I pray, Father, that you will encourage them, that they will stand in the mountaintop of the island and shout with great passion of your love, of the good news of Christ. Father, I pray for the fathers, for the men of the Dominican Republic. I pray, Lord Jesus, that men will step up to lead, to love like you love and led your church. I pray, Lord, also as well for the mothers, for the women and the daughters of the island, that you will equip them, Father, with grace, with purity, with dignity. Make our women of the island, Father, to be your servant, that they will live out life for your glory, that their songs of the heart and the songs of how they live out the life will be a sweet fragrance to you. And Father, pray for the children of the island, that they will recognize the need for a Savior, and they will be set aside, Lord, to be an army of prayer warriors, to rise up to pray for their generation, to pray for those in authorities over them. I pray, Lord Jesus, for the poverty of the island, that you will meet their needs according to the desires of your heart. Father, pray for the neighboring Haiti and for those who have crossed the border and reside in the island. I pray, Lord Jesus, for a spirit of welcoming to them, for a spirit of grace and love and tenderness. I pray, Lord Jesus, for the climate and the weather that comes and sweep the islands up and down. I pray, Lord Jesus, that you'd spare the islands from those natural disasters that seems to come seasonally, for the people to unite together to serve one another in moments of needs. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that you love the island and that you love the Dominican Republic so much that you died for it. It is my prayer that their eyes and minds will be open to experience you as the majestic, almighty God that you are, that the splendor of your glory will be shining through all things. I pray these things for the glory of God by the power of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen.